And we about to start to paint a second layer. This board it's been drying overnight and it's nicely dry. I just want to make sure that you always check your board with your hand and find some kind of some dust spots or needles, whatever it appears that it doesn't feel smooth. Take it with, in this case I took 240 sandpaper, it's already used, so it's more fine than it's new. So kind of fine sandpaper, 320, 240, and take the damp cloth, remove the paint dust, and we're good to go for the second layer. This Victorian gray, it's been already pre-mixed, so you guys don't have to lose time with me, but I'm gonna remind you again, make sure that you stir stick your paint, don't shake the cans, and get it to the consistency of yogurt, okay? And I'm gonna just transport paint from the stir stick and get more paint with my brush cubes. Remember, like I'm turning my brush as a wine bottle and start zigzagging back and forth. So now I have plenty of paint on my brush so I don't have to lose time, go back and forth to the container. I'm gonna use my 1-inch brush like I was teaching you in the first layer for the small edges and corners. Make sure there is no puddles, not too much paint. We remove anything extra. And the rest of the paint that we have on our brush, we transport to the side of the cabinet. And my biggest concern right now to apply paint faster. You see I'm working much faster compared how it was the first layer, because the paint is absorbed into the first layer and it's drying also much faster compared to the first layer. So I just switch on my fringe brush, I did zigzagging, and I'm about to start feathering. I wanna make sure that you guys know that the brush is damp before you start feathering and clean. And when you're feathering, you're not putting any pressure and you go from the top till the bottom or from the bottom to the top and make sure that there is enough amount of paint and the last feather touch would go by the wood grain. And I wanna mention it. If you feel that you are brushing and you have deep brush strokes, means that you have too much paint. That's why I have extra dry brush on the side. And sometimes I will just go over and pick up extra paint, just kind of clean it up and take it up. And then I will do my final. And then I get in my linen fabric feel. Then I have perfect amount of paint, perfect, beautiful, smooth, fine brush strokes, almost invisible. Then I will go with my 1-inch brush, get rid of the paint. I'm just gonna do that on the lid. You see, I'm just pushing this brush, getting the brush completely dry, and we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4 touch up. And then I'm gonna go back with my full of paint, 2-inch, and finalize the edges. Very simple process, but require concentration and non-talking on the phone or I don't know. Some people painting and they think they could do several things at the time and then their paintings looks a little bit confusing to me. So I am always recommending concentration and focusing on your board. It's very therapeutic if you have a nice music in your studio and positive thinking, your positive energy transporting to the work you do and make others happy. And in this case, we are dealing with kitchen cabinets. Kitchen is the most popular place in your home and we wanna make sure that we accumulate as much positive thoughts, energy, emotions to this cabinet and here's our second coat done. As you notice, I left over some dry brush on the side of the edges because I'm planning to distress. And after the board completely dry, I will give it to a couple hours, we will be ready to distress.